Hi, everyone, and long live Blood Bowl!
Yes, that's right, Jim. Another exciting encounter is about to get underway.
Should be a classic, Bob. I spoke to the ref earlier on, and he says he'll be looking to keep a low profile. There's such a difference between the level of the two teams. You've got to be slightly worried.
Oh, no, we have a blizzard moving in.
Yeah, looks like it, Jim. Teams will have to watch that ice on the pitch.
Not only that, Bob, it looks like they can't throw the ball too far either.
Did you know that dwarf runners are trained in the same way as city watchdogs?
No.
Yeah. The coach hides a pint of beer somewhere inside a warehouse, and all the players on the team are then sent to find it. The first one to the beer is named Runner. The ball goes skywards, and the match is on!
Well, there's a rumor going around that the freelance ogre Morgan Thorg, ex-captain of the Chaos All-Stars, may be making a comeback.
Oh, just to think about his career stats make me go weak in the knees. 50 touchdowns by Goblin Throws, 50 running touchdowns, and incredibly, an amazing 617 dead or injured.
Yep, he's the only living player to have made it onto the Wall of Fame.
The mutants! With feet coming out of their backs, a fifth eye, and other bodily parts.
Oh, God.
Especially Margoth Thumgrin.
Yeah, I remember him. His head so resembled a ball, he was decapitated by a black orc from the gouged eye. Yes, it was one of the rare occasions when a team ran in 2 touchdowns with a single play. You remember Rodog Ironhead?
Of course. Leading player for the Chaos All-Stars.
That massive armored body and those razor-sharp metallic claws?
During a stormy game with the Valkyries, he proved to be an excellent lightning rod. Yep, upside down. That's one way to look at things. I doubt he'll be taking any further part in the match after that blow.
No, we've still got 2 legs. That face job is a lot cheaper than a plastic surgeon.
I don't know if he planned it, but it won't do him any harm in the looks department.
Well, there's a rumor going around that the freelance ogre Morgan Thog, ex-captain of the Chaos All-Stars, may be making a comeback.
Oh, just to think about his career stats make me go weak in the knees. 50 touchdowns by Goblin Throws, 50 running touchdowns, and incredibly, an amazing 617 dead or injured.
Yep, he's the only living player to have made it onto the Wall of Fame. Wallop! Right on the schmuzzle.
He'll have a bit of trouble blowing his nose from now on. Incoming!
Well, it is a violent sport.
Ah, The mutants! With feet coming out of their backs, a fifth eye, and other bodily parts.
Oh, God.
Especially Margoth Thumgrin.
Yeah, I remember him. His head so resembled a ball, he was decapitated by a black orc from the gouged eye. Yes, it was one of the rare occasions when a team ran in 2 touchdowns with a single play.
I think she's singing him a lullaby. Ouch! Right in the face! The other guy couldn't dodge that one.
Did you hear about the Evil Gits? The team that is made up of the mix of evil players?
Their fans won the Most Evil Supporters of the Year award. Fully merited from what I've seen. Every now and again, Blood Bowl throws up a real mixed bag of a team.
Like the Motley Horde, that's made up of a bunch of misfits.
Yeah, can't be easy to coach those cast-offs every day of the week.
Well, that's one with a good reason to go see the apothecary.
Yep, looks like he's gonna need a good one.
Looks like there was some bad blood between those two, hey, Bob?
Yeah, Jim. Something to do with swapped body parts.
Thank you.
You remember Rodog Ironhead?
Of course. Leading player for the Chaos All-Stars.
That massive armored body and those razor-sharp metallic claws?
During a stormy game with the Valkyries, he proved to be an excellent lightning rod. You think you'll be able to get up after that blow, Jim?
Oh, yes. He's not the sort to stay down.
There was a time when the Colleges of Magic hadn't yet ruled on limiting wizard assistance to teams.
Who could forget the infamous 2472 Quagmire incident, when rampant spellcasting caused the entire Bright Crusader Stadium to sink into the earth?
Nobody could forget that. People were blinded for miles around the stadium.
Good job there, from a pair of safe hands!
Nice pass! The action goes on! Go! Just like in 98. Ah, the Troll Slayers. You know that their first appearance dates back to 2465 in a match between the Giants and Lowdown Rats.
No, I didn't. You know, me and the dwarves, I...
A blitzer called Stout Iron Fist was given the task of protecting the King's son. However, the Rats managed to blind Stout. And by the time he was able to clear his eyes, the King's son had been killed by the Rat's Troll. Stout, of course, flew into a frenzy and decapitated the Troll.
Ouch. Poor Troll.
Poetry in motion.
What we'd like to see
more often.
While the dwarves have an excellent approach to a match. As they always say, seek out fear to overcome it. Fatigue to go beyond it. Adversity to conquer it.
And the ball if you've got nothing better to do.
Hold still and then pow! Right in the face!
That player's seeing stars now.
Funny for someone that wasn't really that bright.
He's knocked them senseless.
You're assuming then that he had something between his ears to begin with. Well, there's a rumor going around that the freelance ogre Morgan Thorg, ex-captain of the Chaos All-Stars, may be making a comeback.
Oh, just to think about his career stats make me go weak in the knees. 50 touchdowns by Goblin Throws. 50 running touchdowns and, incredibly, an amazing 617 dead or injured.
Yep, he's the only living player to have made it onto the Wall of Fame.
A recent medical report stated that cerebral hemorrhages were less frequent in Blood Bowl players. Amazing when you come to think of it.
Not really, when you consider that brains are also less frequent. The players are positioned and we're off.
Ah, the mutants! With feet coming out of their backs, a fifth eye, and other bodily parts.
Oh, God.
Especially Margoth Thumgrin.
Yeah, I remember him. His head so resembled a ball, he was decapitated by a black orc from the gouged eye. Yes, it was one of the rare occasions when a team ran in two touchdowns with a single play. Nice left punch. Right on the nose.
Sure was, Jim. It's broken now.
We don't see much of the Heroes of Lore these days.
I don't know.
For any spectators who aren't aware, the Heroes of Lore hope to show the world a better way by honest, strategic play on the pitch.
It's probably a good thing we don't see them.
Clean take up there, nothing to say.
And I don't have any remark to add, my friend.
Wizards have not always been able to cast spells safely from behind the sidelines. Were you playing at the time in an Albion League, a second division that prohibited spellcasting from off the pitch?
Oh, yes. They were great times. I remember fans traveling to games just to see how well Wizards stood up to the mad charge of a raving Blood Bowl star. The noise created by a sizzling fireball, followed by the characteristic sound of the snapping of a wizard's neck. What violence!
Yes! It's a great spectacle, Bob. If he hit him any harder, he'd have punched him straight into the infirmary.
Don't worry. That's where he'll be waking up.
That's one regulation clobbering. Just look at the fans. They're red hot. A majority of supporters reckon that the league should take measures to prevent the small minority of peaceful fans from watching a match from the terraces.
They've got a point. If they don't want to join in the fun, they might as well stay home and watch it on Cablevision.
The most famous blocker was probably Pendy No Luck Stonewall. You remember him, Bob?
Oh, yeah. Every time he took a hit, his old mother used to come on the pitch and handbag the culprit. She had a total of 120 KOs during his career. Shame she disappeared during a match against the Lowdown Rats when she tried to spank a troll.
May she rest in peace. Wow! I can tell you straight, that hurts. You remember Rodog Ironhead?
Of course. Leading player for the Chaos All-Stars.
That massive armored body and those razor-sharp metallic claws?
During a stormy game with the Valkyries, he proved to be an excellent lightning rod.
He sent him down for a chat with the Astro Granite.
That reminds me of when I took Griff to bits in the 91 final against Reitland.
Oh, yeah. You kneecapped him.
If insults had any effect on the trajectory of the ball, I guarantee that the dwarfs would be world champions.
Look over there. Some cute little elf beauties are selling big moot sandwiches in the stands.
Hey, I'm off to get one. I'll be back in 5 minutes.
And so now you like big moot sandwiches?
No way! A little elf beauty? Yeah.
That right hook was worthy of a black orc.
You're telling me? It'll take a while to get over it.
Today's insight comes from Jaime Schnivel, coach and owner of the Goblin Lowdown Rats team. In yesterday's Spike magazine, he said that Blood Bowl was like war. No winners, just survivors.
Oh, now that's deep. About as deep as his team's position in the rankings.
As soon as he throws his first punch.
We know the opponent will be out for lunch.
And don't forget, children, don't try and do this at home. Remember, these are seasoned professionals.
Well, one of them is anyway.
You remember Rodog Ironhead?
Of course. Leading player for the Chaos All-Stars.
That massive armored body and those razor-sharp metallic claws?
During a stormy game with the Valkyries, he proved to be an excellent lightning rod.
Now there's one that won't be coming back in a hurry. Look at him go!
Yeah! Clear the runway for a touchdown! Corruption so widespread that the Referees Guild has set up rules concerning where, when, and how one can accept a bribe.
Under an agreement signed last season, the clubs are not allowed to offer less than the going rate. There's a rumor going round that the freelance ogre Morgan Thorg, ex-captain of the Chaos All-Stars, may be making a comeback.
Oh, just to think about his career stats make me go weak in the knees. 50 touchdowns by Goblin Foes, 50 running touchdowns, and incredibly, an amazing 617 dead or injured.
Yep, he's the only living player to have made it onto the Wall of Fame.
Doping is really endemic in this sport.
Isn't it written into the game rules?
And we're off! I've heard of teams that have simply disappeared after being abandoned by their supporters.
Let's say that some teams who haven't won a match for several years have been tied up by their fans and thrown into rubbish containers.
It's the only way to end a downward spiral. That's what happens when a pro crosses an amateur.
Yes, splodge. It seems this player does all the talking with the fists.
And they clearly know how to get heard.
Good recovery.
What was that supposed to be?
I think he tried a pass.
I hope you're joking.
I wish I was.
Okay, it's halftime. No doubt the players will be grateful for a rest.
And the supporters glad for the opportunity to rebuild their stocks of missiles. The most famous blocker was probably Pendy No Luck Stonewall. You remember him, Bob?
Oh, yeah. Every time he took a hit, his old mother used to come on the pitch and handbag the culprit. She had a total of 120 KOs during his career. Shame she disappeared during a match against the Lowdown Rats when she tried to spank a troll.
May she rest in peace.
Did you know that dwarf runners are trained in the same way as city watchdogs?
No.
Yeah. The coach hides a pint of beer somewhere inside a warehouse, and all the players on the team are then sent to find it. The first one to the beer is named Runner.
I don't know if he really liked that uppercut.
He may not have liked it, but he certainly ate it.
That right hook was worthy of a black orc.
You're telling me it'll take a while to get over it.
What does R.I.P. stand for, anyway?
Repose in pieces? If insults had any effect on the trajectory of the ball, I guarantee that the dwarfs would be world champions.
I don't know if he really liked that uppercut.
He may not have liked it, but he certainly ate it.
He's got a hand to the ball.
Yeah, now he's looking around for support. Ah, the mutants! With feet coming out of their backs, a fifth eye, and other bodily parts.
Oh, God.
Especially Margoth Thumgrin.
Yeah, I remember him. His head so resembled a ball, he was decapitated by a black orc from the gouged eye. Yes, it was one of the rare occasions when a team ran in two touchdowns with a single play. as soon as he throws his first punch.
We know the opponent will be out for lunch.
Blood Bowl is reputedly the toughest of all sports.
So they say. But it really only comes down to taking a few hits.
Well, there's a rumor going around that the freelance ogre Morgan Thorg, ex-captain of the Chaos All-Stars, may be making a comeback.
Oh, just to think about his career stats make me go weak in the knees. 50 touchdowns by Goblin Throws, 50 running touchdowns, and incredibly, an amazing 617 dead or injured.
Yep, he's the only living player to have made it onto the Wall of Fame. That's one regulation clobbering. It seems this player does all the talking with the fists.
And they clearly know how to get heard.
This player has opened the slapping box and gives rather generously. You remember Rodog Ironhead?
Of course. Leading player for the Chaos All-Stars.
That massive armored body and those razor-sharp metallic claws?
During a stormy game with the Valkyries, he proved to be an excellent lightning rod.
He checked that move.
Made him look stupid, you mean?
A mouthful of knuckle, and then a mouthful of dirt.
Yeah, he went down face first.
Well, that's one with a good reason to go see the apothecary.
Yep, looks like he's gonna need a good one.
While the dwarfs have an excellent approach to a match. As they always say, seek out fear to overcome it. Fatigue to go beyond it. Adversity to conquer it.
And the ball if you've got nothing better to do. The pitch is no place to lie down for a sleep.
Well, after an uppercut like that, he doesn't have any choice. This player was really strong. Do you think they have some troll blood in them?
Could be. Or maybe his opponent shouldn't speak that way about the family.
The referee's guild has decided to hire a bodyguard for each game.
Another brilliant idea. And just how effective will one bodyguard be against a stadium full of supporters?
True. Could be a bit one-sided.
Incoming!
Well, it is a violent sport.
Nice play with the ball. They've been training well. That reminds me of when I took Griff to bits in the 91 final against Reichland.
Oh, yeah. You kneecapped him.
Ah, the Troll Slayers. You know that their first appearance dates back to 2465 in a match between the Giants and Lowdown Rats.
No, I didn't. You know, me and the dwarves, I...
A blitzer called Stout Iron Fist was given the task of protecting the king's son. However, the rats managed to blind Stout, and by the time he was able to clear his eyes, the king's son had been killed by the rat's troll. Stout, of course, flew into a frenzy and decapitated the troll.
Ouch. Poor troll.
The Blood Bowl annals are littered with the stories of teams who've gone bust with crippling debts.
And with the cost of doping and bribery on the rise, the problem won't be going away.
I think she's singing him a lullaby. You think he'll be able to get up after that blow, Jim?
Oh, yes. He's not the sort to stay down. Nice left punch. Right on the nose.
Sure was, Jim. It's broken now. There was a time when the Colleges of Magic hadn't yet ruled on limiting wizard assistance to teams.
Who could forget the infamous 2472 Quagmire incident, when rampant spellcasting caused the entire Bright Crusader Stadium to sink into the earth?
Nobody could forget that. People were blinded for miles around the stadium. A recent medical report stated that cerebral hemorrhages were less frequent in Blood Bowl players. Amazing when you come to think of it.
Not really, when you consider that brains are also less frequent.
Sure, he's knocked him senseless.
You're assuming then that he had something between his ears to begin with.
If insults had any effect on the trajectory of the ball, I guarantee that the dwarfs would be world champions. Poetry in motion.
What we'd like to see
more often. What violence!
Yes! It's a great spectacle, Bob!
Ouch! Have a nice sleep.
Little baby gets his medicine and he's having a little nap.
Ah, the mutants! With feet coming out of their backs, a fifth eye, and other bodily parts.
Oh, God.
Especially Margoth Thumgrin.
Yeah, I remember him. His head so resembled a ball, he was decapitated by a black orc from the gouged eye. Yes, it was one of the rare occasions when a team ran in 2 touchdowns with a single play. Bet that hurt. Good job his nose got in the way.
Yeah, otherwise he'd have got it full in the face.
Well, there's a rumor going around that the freelance ogre Morgan Thog, ex-captain of the Chaos All-Stars, may be making a comeback.
Oh, just to think about his career stats make me go weak in the knees. 50 touchdowns by goblin throws, 50 running touchdowns, and incredibly, an amazing 617 dead or injured.
Yep, he's the only living player to have made it onto the Wall of Fame. If it wasn't for the blood flowing from his nose and mouth, you'd swear he was having a rest. Wallop! Right on the schmuzzle!
He'll have a bit of trouble blowing his nose from now on.
You remember Rodog Ironhead?
Of course. Leading player for the Chaos All-Stars.
That massive armored body and those razor-sharp metallic claws?
During a stormy game at the Valkyries, he proved to be an excellent lightning rod.
Ouch! That punch knocked his teeth down his throat!
Yes, Jim. That's never a nice sight.
That face job is a lot cheaper than a plastic surgeon.
I don't know if he planned it, but it won't do him any harm in the looks department. Every now and again, Blood Bowl throws up a real mixed bag of a team.
Like the Motley Horde, that's made up of a bunch of misfits.
Yeah, can't be easy to coach those cast-offs every day of the week. Ouch! Right in the face! The other guy couldn't dodge that one.
When he comes round, he'll be seeing double.
If he comes round.
The most famous blocker was probably Pendy No Luck Stonewall. You remember him, Bob?
Oh, yeah. Every time he took a hit, his old mother used to come on the pitch and handbag the culprit. She had a total of 120 KOs during his career. Shame she disappeared during a match against the Lowdown Rats when she tried to spank a troll.
May she rest in peace.
Yep, upside down. That's one way to look at things.
And don't forget, children, don't try and do this at home. Remember, These are seasoned professionals.
Well, one of them is anyway. Ah, the mutants! With feet coming out of their backs, a fifth eye, and other bodily parts.
Oh, God.
Especially Margoth Thumgrin.
Yeah, I remember him. His head so resembled a ball, he was decapitated by a black orc from the gouged eye. Yes, it was one of the rare occasions when a team ran in two touchdowns with a single play. Wow! I can tell you straight, that hurts.
Did you know that dwarf runners are trained in the same way as city watchdogs?
No.
Yeah. The coach hides a pint of beer somewhere inside a warehouse, and all the players on the team are then sent to find it. The first one to the beer is named Runner.
Hold still, and then pow! Right in the face! Looks like there was some bad blood between those two, eh, Bob?
Yeah, Jim. Something to do with swapped body parts. Corruption is so widespread that the Referees Guild has set out rules concerning where, when, and how one can accept a bribe.
Under an agreement signed last season, clubs are not allowed to offer less than the going rate.
Brilliant sidekick to the face. Let's see that again in slow motion.
He checked that move.
Made him look stupid, you mean? Somebody had better stuff some smelling salts under his nose.
But that won't do any good. He'll need extract of Nurgle to put him back on his feet. Well, the dwarves have an excellent approach to a match. As they always say, seek out fear to overcome it. Fatigue to go beyond it. Adversity to conquer it.
And a ball if you've got nothing better to do.
Bet that hurt. Good job his nose got in the way.
Yeah, otherwise he'd have got it full in the face.
We don't see much of the Heroes of Lore these days.
I don't know.
For any spectators who aren't aware, the Heroes of Lore hope to show the world a better way by honest, strategic play on the pitch.
It's probably a good thing we don't see them.
One small step for the scorer, but one huge leap for the team.
You keep saying that, but I have no idea what you're referring to.
Blood Bowl is reputedly the toughest of all sports.
So they say. But it really only comes down to taking a few hits. And they're off!
That face job is a lot cheaper than a plastic surgeon.
I don't know if he planned it, but it won't do him any harm in the looks department. Oh, brilliant sidekick to the face. Let's see that again in slow motion.
Too bad for this team. They needed just some more guts to win the game.
I propose we get back to physical punishment in these cases. It can really help. That matter. That certainly went down well. Just look at the market, Garth.
What did you expect? It had everything. They had victim written on their faces as they traipsed out onto the pitch.
Now some of them have it straped into their backs. They can't have any qualms about that defeat.
What do you expect from a team that can't keep the ball?